Hello and welcome. Today we'll be looking at how to work with angles measured in degrees, minutes, and seconds. The goals of this video are to add angles in degrees, minutes, and seconds, and also to convert an angle measured in degrees, minutes, and seconds to decimal notation, and vice versa. Traditionally, portions of a degree have been measured with minutes and seconds. 1 minute, written with this notation, is 1/60th of a degree. We can also express that as an equation here, or we can state that 60 minutes would equal 1 degree. 1 second, written this way, is 1/60th of a minute. So we can express this in a variety of ways. We can say that 1 second is equal to 1 minute divided by 60, or we could also say that it's 1/3,060th of degree, or 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. So let's go ahead and take a look at how we can add and subtract angles when they're written in this form. So we'll start by just adding this vertically. So we'll add the seconds together. So we have 99 seconds, 77 minutes, and 52 degrees. But we already said a minute ago that 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute, and 60 minutes is equal to 1 degree. So we cannot leave it in this form. So let's take a look at the seconds first. We could rewrite this as 60 seconds plus 39 seconds. But we know that 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute, so we can convert this to 1 minute, and the result would be 52 degrees, 78 minutes, 39 seconds. And now we can address the minutes. 78 minutes can be written as 60 minutes plus 18 minutes. And again, 60 minutes is equal to 1 degree, so our final answer would be 53 degrees. Remember, we get 1 degree from this, 18 minutes, 39 seconds. So again, what we did is first, we simplified our seconds to minutes and seconds, and then we converted our minutes to degrees and minutes. Now let's take a look at a similar process for subtraction of angles written in degrees, minutes, and seconds. Again, I like the vertical method, so let's rewrite this. So the first thing we notice right away is we're going to have to borrow 1 minute to get 60 seconds here. So let's go ahead and rewrite that. 1 minute and 60 seconds. Now we can perform subtraction using the seconds. And notice how we don't have enough minutes here to subtract 37. So what we're going to do is borrow 1 degree and convert that to 60 minutes. So what we'll have is 77 degrees, 61 minutes, 60 seconds. And now we can perform the subtraction. So 60 seconds minus 40 seconds would be 20 seconds. 61 minutes minus 37 minutes would be 24 minutes. And 77 degrees minus 29 degrees would be 48 degrees. And here we have our final answer. Okay, let's take a look at two more examples. Let's go ahead and convert 25 degrees, 24 minutes, 37 seconds to decimal degrees. So we'll need these conversions over here. So we'll leave the 25 as is, but we need to convert 24 minutes into degrees. And here's our conversion. Each minute is equal to 1/60th of a degree, which means we'll have 24/60ths of a degree, plus we have 37 seconds, but each second is equal to 1/3,600th of a degree. So we'll have 37 divided by 3,600 degrees. So from here, we can go ahead and just use our calculator. And let's go ahead and round this to 4 decimal places. So we have approximately 25.4103 degrees. Now the next problem, let's convert 9.518 degrees to degrees, minutes, and seconds. So we know we have 9 degrees. The decimal part of this degree represents a certain number of minutes. So we have 0.518 times, again, this is a fraction of a degree, and each degree would be 60 minutes, so we'll multiply this by 60. That will give us the number of minutes. So this works out to 9 degrees, 31.08 minutes. But now what we want to do is convert the decimal part of this minutes into seconds. Every minute is equal to 60 seconds. So what we'll do now is take our 9 degrees and convert this into seconds. So we'd have 0.08 times 60 seconds. And I've already worked this out ahead of time. It rounds to approximately 5 seconds. So our final answer would be 9 degrees, 31 minutes, and 5 seconds. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching and have a good day.